He selected a small gold bottle with a pepper box top, so that the powder might be sprinkled on any object through the small holes. Very carefully, he placed the powder of life in the gold bottle and then locked it up in a drawer of his cabinet. "At last," said he, rubbing his hands together gleefully, "I have ample leisure for a good talk with my old friend Unc Nunkie, so let us sit down cozily and enjoy ourselves. After stirring those four kettles for 6 years, I am glad to have a little rest." "You will have to do most of the talking," said Ojo, "for Unc is called the Silent One and uses few words." "I know, but that renders your uncle a most agreeable companion and gossip," declared Dr. Pipt. "Most people talk too much, so it is a relief to find one who talks too little." Ojo looked at the magician with much awe and curiosity. "Don't you find it very annoying to be so crooked?" he asked. "No, I am quite proud of my person," was the reply. "I suppose I am the only crooked magician in all the world. Some others are accused of being crooked, but I am the only genuine." He was really very crooked, and Ojo wondered how he managed to do many things with such a twisted body. When he sat down upon a crooked chair that had been made to fit him, one knee was under his chin and the other near the small of his back. But he was a cheerful man, and his face bore a pleasant and agreeable expression. "I am not allowed to perform magic, except for my own amusement," he told his visitors, as he lighted a pipe with a crooked stem and began to smoke. "Too many people were working magic in the Land of Oz, and so our lovely Princess Ozma put a stop to it. I think she was quite right. There were several wicked witches who caused a lot of trouble, but now they are all out of business and only the great sorceress Glinda the Good is permitted to practice her arts, which never harm anybody.